What's over there?
That's the old open-air theatre, he said. Actors used to come from all over to put on performances there in the 40s and 50s, but it hasn't been used in decades.
Okay, stay here.
Daisy took a step toward the edge of the road as Conrad began to dial.
That's what the other detective said.
As she half walked, half slid down the embankment into something she was pretty sure was poison ivy, she moved the flashlight beam around, trying to avoid surprises. But the vegetation was so thick that she seemed to come upon a surprise with every step. One, her shoe sank into some unpleasantly thick, gooey mud. Two, a massive palm tree trunk appeared out of nowhere, and as she swerved to avoid it, she nearly slammed straight into something made of metal. Clearing the vegetation from it, she realised what it was. The white truck. She stood there for a moment, assessing it in the minimal light. The cabin was empty, at least, from what she could see. Both doors were ajar. It had been abandoned back here. Right beyond that, she could see the wrought-iron perimeter fence. Had they gone through, escaped on foot? Stepping closer to it, looking for another opening in the fence and finding nothing, Daisy walked right through a giant spiderweb. Wiping the soft strands from her face, she gave up looking for the hole and neared the structure. She couldn't tell much of it, except that it was made of crumbling stone and rotten wood beams. She saw stone steps leading up to an old stage, and took them, happy to get away from the encroaching nature. Standing on the stage, she moved her flashlight back and forth, illuminating a semicircle of a seating area, risers as far as she could see into the darkness. Though the bushes and trees around it seemed to be ready to swallow it up, and there was even a thick tree growing from the centre of the stage, Daisy could easily imagine the famous of Tinseltown coming out here to enjoy an evening of theatre at Castle Paradiso. She envisioned women in gorgeous gowns, showgirls in costumes, and dancers and singers putting on a show as she moved the light to the enormous forgotten grand piano in the corner.